Thank you for joining us on another episode of CYC Guy Talk. Gathered again with my four group of brothers here with a very controversial issue today. We received an email in regards to a topic that we all have heard about. We all are, you know, in the society of, but specifically related to drinking. The email is pretty much, to sum it up, stating how she was at a wedding reception and her brother was drinking, and he was in high school. They had some alcoholic beverages at the reception, and he's never really had any type of alcohol. What could she do was her question, but the question I have for my group of brothers here is, what are your thoughts on drinking?
Well, in my opinion, I actually had the same exact question, but I asked a few people. I got a lot of different answers, but the one that really makes sense to me logically is, like, especially, I'm assuming he just entered high school and, like, all these pressures are starting. It depends who you're with and what the reason is and, like, the who, what, where, when, why, and how. And not how, and just why. Well, like, it depends who you're with. Like, if it's, I have been in environments, like, at receptions and with my family. Like, if you're closely monitored and you're exposed to it, I guess, in like, a very subtle way, then I think it's okay. Like, and if you know that you only do it with your family and not, like, in the wrong environment.
But I'm glad you brought that up. Don't you think that could possibly be a gateway to becoming an alcoholic?
If you know that you only should do it in the environment.
If you're in high school, how do you know if you're not gonna, you know, become in love with the alcohol consumption and just start doing it every day?
You have to be wise in the beginning before you get addicted. That's how any addiction starts. How do you know that? It's an addiction at the end. Being an alcoholic means you're addicted to alcohol. And any addiction, in the beginning of it, you know. It's, you always make that psychological decision in the beginning. Am I going to do this? Am I not going to do this? And obviously, if you are going to do it and get hooked into it, you know that this can go too far. I should only do this with my family. I should know what environment I'm going to do this in.
You said that you should know when you're getting addicted? That's wrong.
No, I didn't say that you know you're going to get addicted. I said that once you start doing something, you should know. You should know that what your decision's going to do can lead to addiction. Whenever you do anything, whenever anything. Let's take sports. Let's take something that's non-bad, whatever. If you know that if you start playing poker or something of the sort, that you can get addicted.
Last time I checked, poker was not a sport.
No, I switched it because I just realized because it's become a craze. People have become addicted to poker. In the beginning of when you play, you know you have the gateway to become addicted. But you should know that from then you never do it with friends that can lead you into trouble. You only do it with your family, under people that care about you for real.
If you drink with your family, like, besides not them minding drinking somewhere else, you're actually gonna be like, I drank, you might like it, you know what I mean? You're gonna end up finding ways to get a drink. Alright, and if you get one drink, if you don't know what you're doing, you're not gonna stop. Alright, if there's nobody next to you telling you that's enough, or nobody that cares about you to tell you don't do that, you're gonna have a drink, another drink, a third drink, and you won't even notice. By that time, you're gonna be drunk, and you will not notice it. And you don't know the consequences that might happen. That's why you shouldn't start in the beginning, whether with your family or not. Like, for example, smoking. You're going to smoke once. You'll be like, I didn't die. Why can't I do it again?
This is the beautiful thing about this channel is that we're all able to express our opinions. And we all learn from each other's opinions. And that's what this is. This is what I'm learning from you guys. The question I have for you is that, and Mina, maybe you can help me out with this, is, and being that you're a freshman, do you feel that you've been exposed to alcohol and drinking in your high school so far? How long have you been in high school?
3 weeks, but even then, I've already seen lots of alcohol related problems. There's kids who come to school with a hangover. Kids who come to school drunk. Kids have alcohol. They drink it out after school. They're drinking it out on the lawn, throwing cans on the floor. They don't care. They drink. First of all, what I think is underage drinking, you really shouldn't do it at all. Not with your family. It's against the law, and God teaches us to respect the law of where we live.
Mina, by the way, he was one of my Sunday school kids. And he was very well, very well.
I just really want to respond to that. Both Vivnoti and Mina, just to get it clear, said you should never drink ever, ever. And it doesn't say in the Bible you're not allowed to drink. It says you shouldn't drink strong drink nor get drunk. It says it's okay to drink wine.
Don't drink when you're underage. When you're underage.
No, but underage, hold on. I just want to get this clear. Underage with your family is different than underage on your own.
Honestly, guys, I used to drink. Honestly. Okay? So, I know if I grab a drink, alright, okay, I'll drink it, then I'm gonna find a friend coming over, hey, you wanna taste this? Hey, you wanna do this? I'm not gonna tell him, no, it's right in front of me, alright? So, you're gonna get drunk, even if you want to stop, like I said before, you're gonna have your first drink, you'll be like, I'm not drunk yet, and you're probably like halfway through your brain.
Okay, well, hold on 1 second, do you drink now?
No. Thank God.
So you're saying from your own experience, you've notice that when you're in these situations, there are certain situations where you cannot say no.
Yeah.
That you only are going to.
You could, but.
But it's.
It won't feel right. Like, he won't say.
But you're saying he should have said.
Yeah, no, that's a different topic. That's friends. You have to drop those friends.
All right, not even friends. Some of the times I don't even know the guy.
No. Let me just tell you. In my personal experience, I'm 1 year left in high school after this year. I've been in high school for 3 years. I've been in junior high school. My junior high school had a lot of drinking, a lot of smoking. I've drunk in wine and I've drinking champagne at weddings, you know, casually. I generally don't like to, but I do. I do it. Wait. So, and I have never, like, my friends have invited me. If kids in class have invited me to do other things and to smoke other things and to do things, but I've never done it in my life outside of family. There can be limitations. You're saying that once you drink at a wedding, that's it. You're addicted and you're gonna go do it with your friends. I disagree with that though.
I'm not saying that's it, but you're gonna get the taste of it. Your brain is gonna know what it tastes like, how it feels.
I think we, Vivnoti and Mina, you're bringing up some great points. I mean, it's very clear and very safe to assume that A does not directly cause B, but A, as in drinking, can possibly cause B, which is getting drunk and being addicted. So to eliminate A altogether, where there's no possibility of getting drunk or no possibility of becoming an alcoholic, that's a safe bet than from possibly becoming drunk or possibly.
The only thing I disagree with that is that I said in the beginning, although in the beginning of the segment, that if you're not subtly exposed to it, it's been confirmed. Like my friend's like, oh, I'm having a party tonight. There's gonna be drinks. You wanna come? Drinks are free. That's what he said.
But Mina, but that's if I, you.
No, it's not. I'm not saying no. I'm not saying it's just me. I'm saying that if I wasn't like by my parents, like closely and subtly, like allowed to drink wine, allowed to drink, you know, on like famous, like big occasions, then maybe if it was hit with me, like come to a party, have fun, you're guaranteed fun with drinks and whatever, I might have done it since I wasn't exposed to it very like gently. May God, like, God bless me in this fact, because I feel like that if I was invited without drinking before, I might have drunken and done whatever.
But hold on 1 second. The thing I want to bring up to everyone is we have our own personal experiences, and as we discussed in a prior episode, is that experiences are what help us make decisions. And our own experiences from what other people that we love experience. All these different things can help us make the right decisions, but we want to learn how to give advice, and that's what this show is all about. So any advice on those that might be giving in or maybe thinking about giving in to the whole drinking on a general kind of side, not necessarily on a specific end? Because I feel like, Mina, you're talking about you, But not like, if someone listening, maybe in another state, were to take what you said, how do you think on a global scale they might be able to feel?
The only thing that I think I can respond to that, everybody's different, of course. Maybe my situations have been very, blessed in the fact that I wasn't, I wasn't thinking about it too much. I have thought about, a lot of my friends do different drugs and do a bunch of things, but the only thing, not really my close friends.
Different topic on guide.
Yeah. Friends of circumstance did these things, but, the only thing, if you're in a different, situation or a different, situation, and you're faced to drink, it's a path that you might, Bivnoti did, hit the nail on this one, that, it can lead to a path that leads to worse and worse things. The devil doesn't come out and say, reject Jesus. He comes out in very subtle ways and, changes you in that way.
What you said? One of the first times I ever tasted a drink was during class. An iced tea bottle was getting passed around. All right, everybody did it. I'm not gonna just, pop out there, guys, no. Nope. Everybody was laughing, having fun, you know what I mean? I'm not just gonna sit there in my little corner, getting isolated, you know what I mean? Just say no. I mean, I want to, but then again, I'm it's one time, it won't affect you. I tried it that one time. The next day, I found myself at a party. I'm doing something I'm not supposed to be. That's why I was like, you know what? You're gonna do it once, that means you're gonna do it again. Yeah. So just don't do it at all. You're gonna see it. It won't kill you to say no. All right.
Don't do it at all, is your opinion. Amina.
I agree with Bivnoti. You really shouldn't start something that you know may sometimes become a downward spiral. Because I know lots of good kids that, a few years back, I thought they were great. Nothing would ever happen to them. I found a few years later, they're at parties, they get drunk, they get arrested. Things happen to them. It all started with one drink, and then as time goes by, they get drunk.
Good point. George?
I tasted drinks. They're all disgusting. I don't know why anybody would like them. That's my honest opinion.
On that note, that drinks are disgusting, from our friend George, we can definitely say, as we learned from prior episodes and just from our church life and what the church teaches us, that the right friends, the right network, and the right things to do can help us live better. And as Romans 8:28 teaches us, that all things are good for those who love God. So if we do all things for the glory of God, whether it's in our homes, whether it's in our social settings, I'm sure we will all come out to the understand what we should or should not do. And on behalf of my brothers, I want to thank everyone, and please, I urge you to post your questions or your comments onto the website below, the email address below that you see. Thank you, and glory be to God forever. Amen.